Hi everyone, this is Manjula Devi, working as an assistant professor in Department of Pharmacology, Vistas. We are going to discuss the topic on emetics and anti-emetics. Before entering into the emetics, we have to know about the basic of the emetic response. On the vomiting center, that is chemoreceptor trigger zone, that will having the receptor called 5-HT2, and on the vagal afferents we have 5-HT, and on vomiting center we'll have a muscarinic and H1 receptors. These are all the receptors which will we have to target for treating the emesis or inducing the emesis. This is a diagrammatic representation of those receptors which is present in the brain and vagal centers, and there is an inducing the emesis because of smell, pain, slight responses or psychological stimuli or motion sickness, or due to that equilibrium balance will be lost in the ear. And we also use the chemotherapeutic agents that also induces vomiting or nauseatic feeling, and due to the unpleasant sensation also, or any other drug or drug induced or food induced or poison also produces vomiting. This is a center which is present. Higher centers will be present in the medulla oblongata, and the receptor will be D2 and muscarinic receptor, and salivary tract muscles will be present having a 5-HT3, dopamine, muscarinic and histamine receptor. In the chemoreceptor trigger zone will have at a area of brain will have a 5-HT3 that is hydroxytryptamine 3 and D2 receptor, and in cerebellum will have H1 and muscarinic receptor. So each receptors can be stimulated by different types of responses. Based on that, we have to use anti-emetics or induces the emesis. So coming to the emesis, vomiting occurs due to the stimulation of center situated in the medulla oblongata. The chemoreceptor trigger zone is located in the area posterior, and the nucleus, tracheus, solitarius, that is NTS, also important relay areas for the afferent impulses arising in the GIT, throat or other visceral organs. The CTS, that is chemoreceptor trigger zone, is also responsible for the drugs which is accessible to blood-brain barrier, and mediators, hormones and toxin. Because of this unprotected response, it will also produce vomiting. Coming to the emetics, so there are some of the drugs which induces the vomiting or nausea. That is the drugs which act on CTZ, or the drugs which refluxly produced and act on the CTZ. Example is apomorphin and ipecacuanha. So apomorphine is a D2 agonist. It is a semi-synthetic derivative of morphine, act on the dopaminergic agonist and CTZ. Intramuscular or subcutaneous injection of 6 mg dose within 5 minutes induces the vomiting. And coming to the ipecac, it is a dried root of Cephalus ipecacuanha, contains emetin. This is a chemical constituent which is used in the syrup ipecac, that is 15 to 20 ml in adults and 10 to 15 ml in children and 5 ml in infants, to induce the vomiting. It is less dependent than the parental apomorphine. Then it takes 15 to more minutes to produce the effect, but it is safer. It acts by irritating the gastric mucosa as well as the CTZ. The emetics are contraindicated in the corrosive poisoning, CNS stimulant drug poisoning, kerosene poisoning and the unconscious patient. Coming to the anti-emetics, so we have already seen the emetic center and receptors we are going to induce us, refluxly induces a poisoning. So and emesis or vomiting. So those are the targets to stop the emesis or vomiting. So we can say muscarinic receptor, that is anticholinergics. Example are hyoscine, dicyclamine, H1 receptor antagonist, that is promethazine and diphenhydramine, cyclosine, meclizine, neuroleptics, that is chlorpromazine and haloperidol, prokinetic drugs like metoclopramide, domperidone, sesapride also having the anti-emetic property, and 5-HT3 antagonists like ondansetron, which also having the anti-emetic property, and adjuvant anti-emetics are dexamethasone, benzodiazepine and cannabinoids. Coming to the individual drugs, these are the drugs which we are going to discuss about the pharmacological action, ADME or contraindication. Likewise, we are going to see individual drug. First, we are going to see about the hyoscine. It is chemically, it comes under the category of pelodonol alkaloid, and it is a tertiary amine. And therapeutically, it is used as an anti-muscarinic agent and anti-spasmodic agent. And M-muscarinic receptor is present in the vomiting center also, and it is also present in NTS. So it is comes under the category of C. Mechanism and pharmacological action. It is competitively inhibit the acetylcholine at autonomic post ganglionic cholinergic receptor, that is M3 receptor, and because of the most sensitive receptor, it also have a secretions in the salivary gland, bronchial and sweat glands. It also causes GI smooth muscle contraction. So because of that, there will be an increase in GI motility and decrease in gastric secretion. In addition to that, hyoscine causes bladder retrusor muscle contraction, reduces the nasal and oropharyngeal secretion, and decreases the airway resistance from the relaxation of the smooth muscle in bronchi and bronchioles. Coming to the adverse reaction, due to the taking of hyoscine, there is a chances of insomnia, blurry vision, dry mouth, constipation, and impotence. Contraindication or drug interaction, we can say. Drug interaction, if you are giving the hyoscine, we have to possibly increases the anticholinergic effect, and anti-diarrheal effect also can be increased by the anti-hyoscine, and it also increases or the metabolism of ketoconazole, so possibly reduces the ketoconazole absorption. Contraindication, it is contraindicated in acute hemorrhage, hemodynamic instability, glaucoma, hepatic disease, and myasthenia gravis, GI disorder, that is obstructive, ischemia, uropathy, neural disorders, severe ulcerative colitis, tachycardia, and it also has to be contraindicated in toxic megacolon. Indication, hyoscine is used to treat peptic ulcer, GI tract disorders caused by spasm. It also controls salivation, excessive secretion during the surgical procedure. Next group of drugs is promethazin. It comes under anti-emetic, antihistamine, antivertigone, and sedative hypnotic drug, and chemically it is an phenothiazine derivative. Mechanism action, it act on H1 receptor and reduces the allergy signs and symptoms. It also prevent motion sickness, nausea, and vertigo by acting on centrally. It also act on the CTZ, and it also balances the imbalance in the vertebral stimulation and lambrinthin function in the inner ear. In addition to that, it promote the sedation, relieved anxiety by blocking the receptor site in the CNS. Indication, it is used to treat motion sickness, to treat vertigo. It also used to treat the nausea, vomiting associated with the anesthesia and surgery. It also used to treat allergic response. It also used to provide nighttime preoperative and postoperative sedation, and it relieves the apprehension and promotes sleep at night during the night before surgery. Next class is clorpromazine. It is comes under the anti-emetic, antipsychotic, and tranquilizer group. Mechanism of action, it prevents nausea and vomiting by inhibiting the dopamine receptor. It is indicated in the intraoperative control of nausea and vomiting. Next one is a domperidone. It is a D2 agonist. It has lowering the ceiling anti-emetic and prokinetic action. Domperidone crosses the blood-brain barrier. Anti-emetic efficacy is lower than the metoclopramide. The plasma TFF is 7.5 hours. Side effects are dry mouth, loose stools, headache, rashes, galactoria, cardiac atmiosis, and the rapid IV injection. Next one is mosapride. It is a 5-HT4 receptor agonist. It is a prokinetic. It increases the release of acetylcholine and stimulates the GI motility. It also has 5-H3 antagonist property. Next one is metoclopramide. It comes under anti-emetic and upper GI stimulant category, and chemically it is comes under benzamide. Mechanism and pharmacological action, it is a D2 antagonist, weak 5-HT3 antagonist. It act on both dopaminergic and serotonergic receptors. It enhances the gastric motility and antagonizes the neurotransmitter effect and dopamine on the smooth muscle. By altering the mechanical activity in GIT, it increases the gastric emptying and it reduces the GERD. Metoclopramide is also blocks the D2 receptor in the CTZ, so it also used to treat nausea and vomiting. So indications are diabetic gastroparesis, GERD, it is used to prevent the chemotherapy induced vomiting. It also used to prevent the post operative nausea and vomiting. Next group of compound is antoncetron. Antoncetron is used as an antiemetic. It act on 5-HT3 receptor and blocks it. Because of that, it will also act on the serotonin receptors on the CTEZ zone. And it this action is reduces the nausea and vomiting by preventing the serotonin release in the small intestine and blocking the CNS signals. And antoncetron also may bind to the serotonin and mu opioid receptor. Indication is to prevent the chemotherapy induced nausea and vomiting, to prevent the post-operative nausea and vomiting, and to prevent the nausea and vomiting after radiation therapy. Thank you.